Trump should have special forces in Oval Office. Let's cut through it. Thanks to a FOIA request filed by Fox's Brett Baer, we now see that the overwhelming likelihood is that the FBI has committed treason by conspiring to misuse its authority in betrayal of the Constitution, by undermining the outcome of the last presidential election. And now it's readily apparent that the DOJ is trying to cover up its failed coup attempt. Maybe because of the CIA's success in covertly overthrowing so many foreign governments over the years, its famous but incompetent little sibling, that it could succeed at the same thing here at home. Regardless, I concur with Ali Carr that it is time to abolish the FBI, both as it is today and in the form in which it existed for decades. However, no matter what President Trump chooses to do about these latest revelations, we're all better off safe than sorry. Therefore, I think that it's advisable for him to break with tradition and replace, or at least augment, his Secret Service detail with Special Forces military personnel, especially since the Secret Service has a long history of collaboration with the FBI, and not to mention its very questionable record as of late in terms of effectiveness. It's also worth remembering that Robert Mueller is a former FBI director, and I think that given their traitorous behavior, both he and his former bureau need to be reminded who commands the loyalty and firepower of this nation. In fact, I've been arguing for months that more special counsels are necessary, including one to investigate Mueller and Deputy AG Rod Rosenstein. Perhaps a former JAG officer would be the right fit, since no former federal prosecutor can be trusted. To anyone who thinks this sounds extreme, I'd reiterate the extraordinary circumstances in which we find ourselves as a nation and highlight that the president already enjoys military protection whenever he travels aboard Air Force One, as do members of America's diplomatic corps at our embassies and consulates. Of course, great care would need to be taken in the selection of the particular military personnel for this mission, and on top of the obvious factors like training and experience suited to the role, each individual operator would need to be free from any outside influences which could impact their abilities, loyalty, or raise questions later should force become necessary. Given everything that is going on, I'd feel a lot better if the president were surrounded by special operators, men of conscience and secret commitment, whose loyalty has never wavered, sworn to carry out the lawful orders of their superiors, including commander-in-chief, and to protect this nation from all threats, both foreign and domestic. Wouldn't you?